Okay, in this video, we are going to solve this example for the exam. In this example, we have this robot, serial robot. With at first sight, we can see that we have 2 degrees of freedoms, theta 1 and theta 2. And also we have these parameters, L1, L2, and beta, L3. And the problem is asking to solve for the forward kinematics equation, inverse kinematic equations, forward velocity equations, inverse velocity equations, and the singular configurations. So we are going to assume that the parameter beta is going to start from this position and then going to an angle different from zero in this direction, from here to here. And also, we are going to assume that theta 1 and theta 2 only going to work for the 0 to 360 degrees. Now, for the solution, let's make a front view for this robot, and then as we can see here, we have the plane X and Z for this robot, and it's easy to see that theta 2 is not affecting the position of the N effector here. The only degree of freedom that is affecting the position is theta 1. And the only locus of the world space that we can see here is this circle with this perimeter. Also, as we can see here, that this is a circle, is only necessary one coordinate to make a position for the N effector. In this case, we can select for the X coordinate or the Z coordinate. In this case, we are going to select the Z coordinates to locate the N effector position. So this is the case when N equals M equals 1. Now let's start for the forward kinematic equations. In forward kinematics equation, we establish the B coordinate system that is going to follow the motion for the theta 1 and the C coordinate system for the position. In this case, is the position given by the beta angle, that is a constant, in order to locate the N effector position. So, in this case, the idea is to obtain a matrix transformation, homogeneous transformation matrix that relates the C coordinate system with respect to the A coordinate system when we know what is the position of the N effector point with respect to the C coordinate system, and then it's possible to obtain the coordinates with respect to the A coordinate system. That is the variables that we need to obtain for the position of the N effector with respect to the A coordinate system. And in order to obtain this homogeneous transformation matrix C with respect to A, we need to multiply two transformation matrices. One is the B with respect to A coordinate system times the C with respect to the B coordinate system. And the last point, P, is with respect to the C coordinate system, that in this case, the only magnitude that locates the N effector point is with respect to the parameter L3 and is in the direction of the positive direction of the X axis. That's why we have L3, 0, and 0. Now, analyzing this homogeneous transformation matrix, For the first homogeneous transformation matrix that relate the V with respect to the A coordinate system, we need to obtain this rotational matrix and this translational matrix. In this case, the rotational matrix is with respect to the Y axis and angle theta 1 in the positive direction with respect to the right hand rule to this Y axis. So this is our basic rotational matrix. And also we have a translational motion from the origin of the A coordinate system to the B coordinate system that is with respect to a distance L1 along the Z axis in the positive direction. Now, the next homogeneous transformation matrix C with respect to B, again, we need to obtain the rotational basic matrix and the translational matrix. In this case, the change that we see here is this rotational, again, with respect to the Y coordinate system, except that in this case is in the opposite direction following the right-hand rule. So that's why we are going to change the sign here by the negative sign. And also is around the y-axis, and also the distance between the origin of B and C is a magnitude L2 along the x-axis in the positive direction. And then let's substitute in this matrix multiplication doing these operations and also using these trigonometrical identities in order to reduce these components of this matrix, we finally obtain our homogeneous transformation matrix that relate the C and A coordinate system. Then, using our forward kinematics model, we obtain finally our forward kinematics equation. As you remember, we can select one of these, x, the coordinate x or the coordinate z. Either x or z is going to define the position of the net vector. And we can check that relationship within these two coordinates. We, using these two equations, and then squaring both sides of this equation and adding these two equations and using this reduction for this equation here, we can see that this equation here are very similar to our equation of the circle that has a origin in the x axis but a displacement with respect to the y-axis at b distance, in this case is L1, and this is the radius of this circle that in this case is this term in this equation. So we can see here it's possible to relate these two coordinates of the net vector if we select as we said that we select the set coordinates, we can find an equation of x in function of the set coordinates. Okay, now for the inverse kinematic equations, we are going to use one of these equations. Remember that this is the case when we have 1 degree of freedom, theta 1, and one coordinate, in this case is the set coordinate.